Now, 2010 might not have been as bad as 2009, but what about 2011 as we look from our position here at the back end of the year? With us now to look ahead is David Buik from BGC Partners. David, it has been an interesting year. There have been marginal increases in equities. What should we take away from 2010?
I think our inability to decouple the performance of equities away from the background of what looked like a pretty dodgy economy on a global basis. When we think about it, since the debacle of 2008 and 2009, companies have now got themselves mean and lean. They're also getting quite profitable, and we have been encouraged and surprised by the quality of the last three quarters' earnings. And there's no reason to suppose that the fourth quarter earnings won't be just as good. You put that together with getting decent dividends from a number of companies, particularly in the UK, when 70% of the earnings of the FTSE 100 companies come from abroad, and it's a pretty attractive prospect. Take that away, what are the alternative assets? Do you really want to go into the bond market, which is crying with pain and with the possibility of implosion in certain areas, where you're also seeing the yield on even the better run countries, such as the United States, Germany, and to a lesser degree, the UK, with bond yields going up? It's a pretty unattractive background to be invested in bonds if you're going to lose money.
But surely one has to ask the question as to why are yields rising? I mean, there are risks out there, some quite serious risks, and we've dealt with some of them this year in terms of borrowing, lending to economies that are showing all the signs of just falling apart. Greece and Ireland, of course, Portugal, possibly Spain next year.
You strip out China and you strip out Germany, the world is dramatically overborrowed, and people have to face reality that this has to be cut. I'm not against quantitative easing, but the jury is definitely out as to whether it works. And you can do a combination of cutting public expenditure as well as keeping quantitative easing in there to keep confidence boosted. And I have my doubts whether enough countries have the ability, let alone the will, to be able to cut public expenditure without severely damaging their infrastructure. And if that is the problem, is that in Europe particularly, when you've got this threat of contagion, it is an issue.
Is there enough heat in the Chinese and the German economies and others that are doing well to keep the rest of the world going?
I believe there is. We've had a consistent supply during the course of the last week in the United Kingdom, whether it be unemployment, whether it be employment, manufacturing output, industrial production, to give us some encouragement that we are getting orders to export our goods, that we are refocusing the economy away from the service sector, which we relied on for far too long, towards export. And I think the signs are very encouraging. And I think we're seeing it in the United Kingdom, and again today in Germany in the last couple of days, we've had one or two setbacks, but again, the strength of the German economy is there, as it is, I believe, with France. Take this together with Asia, and perhaps a rather stuttered recovery in the United States, and we've got the basis of a recovery.
When we're raising a glass to 2011. Will you be looking ahead to 2011 with an excitement, or is there a bit of dread there?
There's the fear of contagion. That'll always be there in the background, but we've lived with it for the last 3 or 4 months as well. And I see absolutely no logical reason for deserting equities, and I still believe it'll be the number one asset class for 2011, based on the fact I believe companies will deliver profits together with satisfactory dividends.
What are the risks, though, for 2011, do you think?
The risks are that the world's governments don't pay attention to their problems, they don't cut their coat according to their cloth, which could lead to high rates of unemployment and a recession. Against that background, we have a problem. I believe the majority of countries realise that the chips are down and that they have to deal with this problem.
One last question. Do you think we'll see higher interest rates from central banks at the end of 2011?
No.
Than at the beginning?
I think it'll be 2012 before we see the slightest increase in official interest rates. As I've said, we've seen bond yields go up, but in the case of the United States of America, where I think we take the lead from this, they could not sustain an increase in interest rates. The housing market would die on its feet, and so would industry and commerce. So rates are fine on an official basis, but unofficially, if bond prices go up, it has a very adverse effect on the economy because you have to sustain debt at the higher level.
Okay, well, here's to 2011. Okay,
absolutely.
David, thanks indeed. David Buik there from BGC Partners.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorised by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.